Welcome to Intermediate Financial Accounting 1, Tutorial 3 on Other Comprehensive Income. This short tutorial will expand on the Endeavor Corporation example contained in Tutorial 1, this time with emphasis on the presentation of other comprehensive income in an IFRS Statement of Comprehensive Income. This tutorial has only one learning objective, and that is to review the presentation of other comprehensive income, also known as OCI. This tutorial is based on the Endeavor Corporation A example that is covered in Tutorials 1 and 2. It is recommended that you review Tutorial 1 before proceeding with this tutorial. However, Tutorial 3 can be reviewed independently of Tutorial 1. Make sure that you download the related file so you can follow along. The requirements for the Endeavor Corporation A example were to prepare an IFRS Statement of Comprehensive Income and prepare an ASPE statement. It is in this Statement of Other Comprehensive Income that we will focus on the OCI section. When it comes to the Statement of Comprehensive Income, IFRS International Accounting Standard IAS 1.10A actually allows for the option of using one or two statements to present other comprehensive income. This illustration is electing to use the single statement option. So here, only the IFRS Statement of Comprehensive Income from Tutorials 1 and 2 is presented, with the OCI section highlighted here in yellow. The title for the single statement option is Statement of Comprehensive Income. The presentation of other comprehensive income is shown only for IFRS, and therefore the content and approach contained in this tutorial is applicable to IFRS only. And now here's the two-statement option. On the left is simply an income statement, or it could be called a statement of profit, that basically ends with net income. Then the second statement is the statement of comprehensive income. Again, both of these are for the year ended. On the right, the statement of comprehensive income starts with a net income and then shows the OCI section. The OCI section is the same as the single statement option. You'll probably start to notice here that there are two subsections. You see here a classification for items that may be reclassified subsequently to profit and loss. And the example that we've given here is the gain on revaluation of assets. Suffice it to say that at this point, you don't have to be concerned about what this revaluation is. This is covered in a later chapter. But this type of gain or loss is something that could end up being reversed back into net income at some point later on. And so that's why it's disclosed in the OCI section. There are other items like this one in green here that will not be reclassified subsequently to profit and loss. And so an example of this is the unrealized holding gains and losses on the available for sale investments, also known as fair value through OCI investments. The point is the OCI section has to be split up into these two subcategories if items belong or if items exist that should be classified. If there's only one classification and the OCI section only includes items that are reclassified to profit and loss, then that's all you show. You wouldn't need to show a second section. The remainder of this tutorial will focus only on other comprehensive income, or the OCI section of the Statement of Comprehensive Income. Regardless of whether the single statement or two statement approach is adopted, the OCI section comes after net income. If no discontinued operations section exists, then net income would equal income from continuing operations. Here again, we have the OCI section that's broken out by these two sub-classifications, items that may be reclassified subsequently to profit and loss, and then items that will not be reclassified subsequently to profit and loss. This is actually referred to as disclosing or presenting the OCI section by nature, the nature being subsequently reclassified or not subsequently reclassified. For the gain on revaluation of assets, the problem tells us that the gain on an after-tax basis is $1,635,000, and so we have to do a backwards calculation to determine what the tax implication of that is. So if we take $1,635,000 divided by 0.65, because the tax rate is 35%, and then we multiply that by 35%, we will get $880,000. And then the same thing here for the unrealized holding loss on AFS investments. Again, at 378 divided by 0.65 brings you back to a before tax, and then times 35% will get you 204. So what we have in the OCI section is a $1,635,000 gain net of tax on a revaluation of assets. And we have a $378,000 loss on available for sale investments, net of a tax benefit of $204, resulting in other comprehensive income of $1,257,000. And so if we combine the $1,257,000 with the net income of $3,389,000, that gives us total comprehensive income, and that's what we call it when we combine the net income and the other comprehensive income, total comprehensive income of $4,646,000. Let's now take a moment to review some key points to remember. First, OCI is applicable only under IFRS and should not be reported under ASPE. Second, OCI is the last section on an IFRS statement of comprehensive income. So it comes after net income, after discontinued operations. Finally, single and two-statement options are possible, with net income being the starting point for each one. And finally, remember that other comprehensive income should be presented by nature, and the nature that we see in OCI can either be items that will be reclassified subsequently to profit and loss, or items that will not be reclassified subsequently to profit and loss. This concludes Tutorial 3 on other comprehensive income.